And welcome to my channel. Today it is an impromptu video. I didn't plan this one, but I ordered some sketching stuff, pencils, a new quill or mop, and a paintbrush from Pantel. I also ordered some watercolor paper, but it's on the expensive side, so I don't feel comfortable painting on it just yet. So I bought these things for Ink October. And I am just very eager to try my watercolors out once again. It's been a couple of years, I think, since I painted last time. And it is very intimidating at the moment. So I will just try some colors out and try the pens just for fun. And I thought maybe you would like to come along. So the technique I've used when I paint my landscape pictures is the technique which Ron Ranson came up with. And there's a couple of YouTubers I follow on YouTube who use this, the large hake, and they make just the most awesome pictures. However, for me, I find this a little bit on the big size for me, so I've come to enjoy this one more, and it's the medium size. It's still the hake, but it's just a medium. I think it's an inch big. But today I want to try out my new mop, and it's a size 1. It's a Raphael. And I'm not sure if my camera will focus because it's a white background. So that's why I'm putting up some paintbrushes there. And these three are different riggers. So it's a 10-0, this one, this small one. This is the number 1 in the middle. And I think this is the number 1 as well, but it's another... the Winson and Newton professional, but it's very soft. Yes, and they don't stand up. Let's do like this instead. Okay, so I have a palette here, and these colors here are actually the Dr. Martin colors, and you just need a couple of drops to use them, and I don't want to use these now. So I brought out some cheaper watercolors. It's the Rembrandt. I have Alizarin Crimson, Azo Yellow Medium. I have some French Ultramarine and Burnt Sienna, and we have the Burnt Umber. And what's this? This is a Cotman, and it's a light red. This is a Winsor Newton, and it's raw sienna. Didn't I have that? Oh, I think I had burnt sienna. Yeah. And the last one is Payne's Gray, and this is a Daler Rowney artist color. So I will put some of these on the palette, and we will just, yeah, try them out. I'm very nervous about this because it's been quite a while. Oh, I think this one is dried shut. No. It's been a while. and I don't know what to paint. But if you don't get started, you will never get started. Which one didn't I put? Maybe it's the glycerin. Ugh. I think these watercolors has gone old actually. The yellow? Yes, the yellow. And I don't have a special way to put the colors. Not like this, anyway. So, I put them there and you can see I think they're a bit old, but didn't I get the light red? What was that then? Oh, it was the burns, yeah. Let's get some red as well. Yes. So, these are the colors, and now I'm supposed to remember. So this was the alizarin crimson, the ultramarine. Don't know. Azo, yellow, paints gray, light red. So this is the burnt umber. And this must be the burnt sienna then. And this must be raw sienna. Yes. Okay. So I'm very curious of my quill. So now I'm not gonna paint anything fancy. I'm just gonna, you know, try it out. So first I took the paints gray and I put some alizarin crimson in there. Now I took the burnt umber. Clouds with your paper tissue or not. I think maybe there will be a background there. Let's try some other colors. Let's do the siennas. Oh, that's a nice yellow. That's the azo yellow. Very nice. Mix some greens. Oh, I put some water down here. Wow. Look how it just runs away like that. Now take ultramarine and some Payne's gray. Look at that color. Yeah, and I kind of get quiet when I start doing this. Put some reds in there, that's too much red. And that was too much water, so you'll get a background. What else do we have? What's this burnt sienna? It's also very nice. What happens if we put some yellow and sienna? Not enough. Let's get some water in there. So of course I started with a dark color. It's hard to get you can't paint over dark color with light. It was a nice dark brown I got, and the green I got there. The red here, or the pinkish red, is glycerin crimson. attractive and beautiful color. What was I thinking? Yeah, I wanted to try out a rigger actually. And there's another thing I want to try out. Take some yellow touch it run the other way. So I turned it upside down. You can create kind of cool trees this way, I think. See? That looks like a big old tree in my eyes, anyway. So I want some darker stuff here. It ran down, back down, so. Let's see. I wanted want something dark here. And I need, I guess, a lot more pigment for it to stop running. So when it's dried, you can use the rigger for some dry painting. You can make grass straws like this. Some trunks. You can write your name. I find that very difficult though. I usually just do like this. Yeah, it's very difficult. Now I will make a wash. No, I will wet the paper. And I will try to make some mixing of colors. See if I can get some some really dark. So now I think I'm starting to mud up, make the get some muddy colors, I think. Oh yeah, maybe it's too wet for that. I could scrape in some things. It's too wet still. Kind of like it as it is. So when the color gets dry enough, you should be able to scrape in, see, some tree trunks. So that was one thing. You can never be good at anything if you don't start to try it out, right? Let's do the other one as well for fun. So I'm just doing some yellow background, and then I will take some blue, some Payne's gray. Some burnt umber. Yeah, some darks in the sky there. Then I will take alizarin and ultramarine and Payne's gray. Paint some hills if I can, in the background. I'm trying to do some form of clouds. I'm gonna soften that edge. I can't remember how I usually did this. Maybe I just used some yellows. Do some maybe some greens in the background. Need some darker green up in the front. Maybe adjust the bush. I don't know. And we want some burnt umber. And marine, ultramarine. Do the paint. think I use ultramarine the most. Couple of birds. Same here, I think. Oh yeah, I was supposed to use my sketching pens. That's true. I should do that. Yes, I will do that. Whoop, that was very dark. That was kind of fun doing these small trunks. But it's too, you know, 1, 1, 1. Let's just do it like that. I want something more here, I think. Something. Taking out. Think that's okay. Whoops. Some water there on the brush. I wanted to do some more dry brushing here and think they should dry first before I start anything. You know, you can use your hair dryer. So when I'm using the hake, it holds a lot of water. Then I'm not using tissue paper to dry it off with water. I have like a towel, actually. Oh, we have to try. It's 0.3. And yeah, I don't know. You should start easy with some small. I think I can take the smallest one. It's a 005. Oh, I'm sorry. for pushing the camera. And I wanted to do some thin trunks. Oh, now I ruined that. So in my mind, I see trees, right? That could almost be the woods on fire, and you see the fire lighting up the sky behind the dead trees. Huh? Yeah. Well, it was fun. It was very spontaneously, and yeah, at least now I got to do it. Now you, when this is dried, you can go in and paint negative space, for example. And oh, I wanted to try my paintbrush as well. I don't know how it works. I've put in this thing. It's ink in there. And I don't know if you have to hold it upside down. Yeah. It's coming. So yeah, maybe I don't remember how you pick up I wanted to pick some paint up and I don't have one of those scrubbies, I think. I'm not sure, but that will do. I think that's kind of okay. I want a sharp edge. Okay, Let's see if I've gotten some paint. Yes, look, wow. So if you want some darker areas to get some more contrast, you can use your brush pen. That didn't turn out so well. But yeah, this was kind of fun, wasn't it? For me, anyways. I'm sure that if you do something like this every day, it's gonna improve your skill for sure. What I'm doing now, I've gotten the inspiration from Steve Mitchell, who does some amazing spontaneous paintings. And I highly recommend you go take a look at his videos. I've mentioned him before, so I will link his YouTube channel in the description below. And you can go take a look. Yeah. So I'm sorry I forget to talk when I start painting, or, you know, diamond paint. I think it's more one. Yeah, unfortunately, my camera only records 30 minutes at a time, and I lost track of time. I tried to keep, keep track, but unfortunately, the last maybe 5 minutes got lost. Anyway, you can see the results of the paintings. So I apologize for my head sticking up in the camera too, quite a lot. I tried to cut parts away of the movie, of course. Oh. Anyway, I just want to say thank you for watching. If you have any comments, please no. Yeah, if you have any comments, please leave them below. Even also, if you have a question, leave a comment below. And please don't forget to hit subscribe, because then I'll see you next time. Take care. Bye.